A Bernalillo fisherman gets the shock of his life.
He reeled in a bizarre catch on the banks of the Rio Grande. Rod Green joins us with a fishtail right out of the Amazon basin.
That's exactly right. I know you guys are thinking about wrapping up your summer with a cool dip in the sparkling clear Rio Grande. Well, this story should make you think twice. There are some unusual critters down there. According to contractor Ray Quintana, it started out as a little spontaneous Monday night fishing expedition with his wife down by the Alameda Bridge. It soon turned into something else.
Fishing with, for little catfish, we're catching little catfish just to entertain ourselves. And then all of a sudden, this little guy here, I had my rod, my line, and I was like, oh, okay, this is a bigger, little bigger one.
Ray says he reeled in his catch expecting a slightly larger catfish.
We had the lantern, and it was like, wait a minute, this is not a normal fish for the river here.
The color, the shape, the teeth, all added up to one thing for Ray. He's convinced he hauled in a dreaded flesh-eating piranha from a place where he'd been waiting from time to time.
Gives me second thoughts. Who to know, you know?
Not that we doubted Ray's story, but I couldn't tell a piranha from a perch, and before we unleashed a wave of terror along the river, I decided to consult with the experts at UNM.
It's definitely a South American fish.
Professor Tom Turner runs the Museum of Southwest Biology. He knows our fine fin friends very well, and he says,
this is commonly called a paku.
It is a kiss and cousin to the piranha, but Turner says this critter prefers veggies over meat. Still, Ray Quintana is not disappointed.
This is going to be the most memorable catch, yes. It's going to be.
Best fish story, huh?
The best fish story.
Professor Turner says this is only the second paku caught in New Mexico, and he's adding it to his collection at the museum. He thinks someone may have purchased the fish for their aquarium, then decided to let it go for some reason, probably because it got too big.
How neat. And Professor Turner also says the first sign of cold weather and the fish would not have survived. It needs tropical waters.